Okay, you know what? At the Texas Daily, we are on the cutting edge of, we have our finger on the pulse of what's happening. And here's one for you, a new trend. Older Americans, many of whom have already retired from successful careers, they've raised a family in many cases, and they're going back to school in record numbers. Not just onesies and twosies, but lots. And our man on the street, or on the campus, Don Wall, just got back from class, and he joins us now to explain what's going on, Don.
Hi, Jeff. I just got back from Emeritus College, which is like a health club for the brain for people 50 and over. It's a program put on by the University of North Texas, and it reflects the national trend of older Americans going back to school.
As you know, the actual election of the president...
Imagine going to college for the sheer sake of learning, with no tests, no homework, no pressure, no expectations. That's what Emeritus College at the University of North Texas is all about.
I think that our population doesn't think it's getting old. I think our population is looking at what's next. What is next in my life, and what kinds of things can I do to absolutely maximize managing the clock at the end of the game is what I like to see.
More than 400 students, all over 50, pay only $140 a year and can take more than 150 non-credit college classes at UNT, Texas Women's University, and Robson Ranch. Taught by active and retired professors, this class on the American presidents is taught by Tom Twidell, a retired airline pilot and flight instructor who is now teaching American history.
You discover a lot of times that you have an interest and an aptitude that you never knew about. That's what I've done here. I never really had any interest in history when I was in school. But now, all of a sudden, in doing all this research, I have developed an interest in history.
He describes Francis Scott Key writing the Star Spangled Banner as the British bombed Fort McHenry during the War of 1812.
The British flag, we lost. If it's an American flag, we won. Well, when the sun finally came up, they saw Old Glory.
So it's just a great opportunity, close to home, to come and be educated, no homework, no tests. This is the best.
Actively learning, continue to explore life, and I'm just excited about living life again. Yeah.
I find it's entertaining. This is, it's giving me something else to talk about instead of the dull being a retired person. This is exciting stuff.
I've just come back to Denton in my retirement, and this is a great addition to sitting on the beach or playing tennis or doing the golf or the other stuff. This is a little bit extra that you can, oh yeah, my mind hasn't completely atrophied.
And you don't have to take any tests, and you don't have to do any prep work. And it's just wonderful. It's kind of like what you always wish that college classes could be, in the sense that it's really low stress.
And the classes could be about anything: history, art, religion, science, current issues, health and well-being. Just search Emeritus College UNT and it'll take you to the website. Pretty good program.
Cool. And welcome back to the Man Show.
Yeah.
Right here. Nothing but guy talk all the time. Don, that's a great story. So were you encouraged? Are you going to maybe take a class?
Oh, sure. I would be happy to take classes. Yeah. In fact, they invited me to teach a class.
Ooh,
I don't know what I might teach, but who knows?
You have a lot to impart.
Wisdom.
A lot to impart.
Very good.
But you know, this is a trend that's happening all over the country.
Nationwide, yeah.
And in, all over Texas, too. And in all of our sister cities, the community colleges offer things like this, and the universities as well. So this is something that, it's really a trend, and it's...
I'm just curious, did any of the participants in the class talk to you about the health benefits of staying active mentally?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, they're talking about physical education, I mean, physical fitness and mental fitness all at the same time, nutrition. You know, we're part of a different culture of aging people. We're a culture that wants to take care of ourselves and enjoy life and get the most out of
it. Keep going.
Keep going.
Okay, great story. Thanks, Don.